Go on, push it, faster.
Right, okay, this is a classic example of like mistakes that most people make when trying to do hill sprints for the first time,
right.
Is they kind of pick a place, pick a distance,
yeah.
And they try and get to a certain distance, okay?
Yeah.
This is not the object, it's not the goal, distance is not the goal.
Okay.
It's better to actually have a shorter distance, but run much faster,
okay.
And burn out much quicker.
Right.
This is all about intensity.
Yeah.
So if we kind of like slow down the speed, slow down the power, we can go much further, but the intensity's dropped. I'd rather see you get to this place here and collapse here,
yeah.
Rather than running twice as far. It's not about how far you run, it's about power and intensity.
Yeah.
So your body has a natural tendency to be slightly more endurance based.
Okay,
you could probably do long distance running, cycling quite well, etc. But sprinting,
okay.
This is something you're going to have to really work at being more explosive from.
Okay.
So from the word go, one of the most important principles is don't look where you're going, because that's not the goal. The goal is speed. So you should be looking one, two steps ahead.
Yeah.
Try and get there quick, and once you're there, you go faster, 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 faster. Okay.
Yeah.
It's all about power and intensity. If you do high intensity cardio properly, you should feel pretty wiped out,
yeah.
Almost sick, a bit dizzy, a bit faint for about 20 minutes, half an hour.
Yeah.
Then you'll get a really big high. Remember, high intensity cardio is all about shocking your body by short, explosive cardiovascular movements. Okay, this particular type of training is very good for your fast twitch muscle fibers in your legs. The fast twitch muscle fibers are the fibers that a bodybuilder aims to increase in size, because they respond to growth rather than slow twitch fibers.
And they're more anaerobic in nature.
You've got different types of fast twitch fibers.
Okay.
You've got on the extreme end, your biggest ones are completely anaerobic.
Okay.
Whereas your smaller ones are kind of a mixture of
right.
the two.
Right.
So what we're hitting the very, very, very top fast twitch fibers
right.
when doing hill sprints. And you're really hitting them hard.
Yeah.
So if you did this, say, once a week, once every 10 days,
yeah.
you will be able to notice an increase in performance in that you should be faster. Remember, I'm not concerned about distance. You don't want to be going any further. This is not endurance.
Yeah.
This is all about intensity and power.
Yeah.
So you should be getting faster each time you do it.
Something I realized today is what you had me doing was a shorter distance, more intense. I've been doing this, but I'd been going further distance for up to 60 seconds, 90 seconds, which necessarily was less intensity, because it has to be to get that far, doesn't it?
Yeah, because what people do when they train is they're so unaware that what their job is to do is to override the body and almost get themselves into that state of fight or flight and emergency.
Yeah.
So they're in that extreme-like state.
Yeah.
So your body doesn't want to be pushed to that degree. So it would rather slow down slightly,
yeah.
just so you can go a little bit further, so you can feel like you've done a good job.
Right.
When really that's not a good job.
This is the problem with setting a target, like a distance or an amount of time or a number of reps. Your body will naturally, you'll pace yourself as opposed to having full intensity as the goal.
Absolutely right, man. Your unconscious mind, if you go, right, that's the distance I'm getting to, I'm going to go to that distance, your body will pace you to get there.
Right.
If you go, right, I'm going to do 10 reps on this set, your body will pace you to get there.
Yeah.
Whereas if you go, right, I've got no idea how many reps I'm going to do on this weight, might do 10, might do 15, might do 8, but I'm going to put everything I've got into the first rep so that I've got maximum power.
Yeah.
Then your intensity is going to be much higher, and you're going to handle that weight better, and you're going to push your body harder.
Yeah, perfectly clear. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.